To help us learn about the celestial sphere, let's talk a little bit about how we define locations on Earth. Knowing what we know today, that the Earth is in fact rotating, we can define the rotation axis as piercing through the Earth's north and south poles, and we can divide the Earth into northern and southern hemispheres from the equator. And we can draw parallels to the equator. So we define the equator as having 0 degrees of latitude, going all the way up to 90 degrees north latitude at the North Pole, and define southern latitudes going all the way to 90 degrees south latitude at the South Pole. Most of us live somewhere in between. We can define longitude first by starting off with the prime meridian, which goes from the North Pole through Greenwich, England, to the South Pole. And from there, we can define what are called meridians of longitude. And this is what divides the Earth into eastern and western hemispheres. So I live near Baltimore. That is somewhere about 39 degrees north latitude and 76 degrees west latitude. Cerro Paranal, Chile, is home to the European Southern Observatory, and that's at 24 degrees south latitude, 70 degrees west. And Rome, Italy, for example, is at 42 degrees north latitude and 12 degrees east. So that puts Rome on the same latitude, approximately, as Boston, Massachusetts in the United States. Okay, well, going back to this idea of the celestial sphere, let's start by taking the Earth's poles and projecting them onto the sky, and that gives us the north and south celestial poles. And we'll take the Earth's equator and project that onto the sky, giving us the celestial equator. So this, in total, is the celestial sphere. Now, we know today that, no, the stars are not really imprinted on an actual sphere, but it's a useful fiction. It allows us to identify not only the positions of stars in the sky, but to help us understand their apparent motion around us. So now we can depict the sky above us. I've positioned us here in Baltimore, Maryland. So if you look down here, I've got our location on the map. You'll see that we're at 39 degrees north latitude and about 76 degrees west longitude. And here we are on Earth as well. So we have the north celestial pole and the south celestial pole represented. The Earth's equator has been projected onto the sky to give us the celestial equator. And I've gone ahead and just added a few stars at random. On the right side of the diagram is our horizon illustration. So here we are, standing on our horizon. The celestial equator is projected onto the sky, so the celestial equator is, well, I don't want to say visible because we don't actually see the celestial equator, but it does pass through our sky here in Baltimore. The zenith is directly overhead. The meridian goes from due north through the zenith to due south and back around again. And the nadir is beneath us. So the celestial poles are presented in both diagrams as well. And you notice that the north celestial pole is some altitude above our horizon. Meanwhile, the south celestial pole is beneath our horizon, hidden from our view. So now let us imagine riding, if you will, along different parts of the Earth. And this is going to help us understand the apparent motion of stars. So let's go ahead and begin our animation. And you'll see that the Earth is rotating. In reality, the stars are fixed, if you will, on the celestial sphere. But from our perspective on the ground, the stars appear to be rising somewhere in the east and, for the most part, setting somewhere in the west. So to help us understand this motion better, we're going to go ahead and jump from Baltimore all the way to the North Pole. Well, what's going on up here? We're standing at the top of the world, so to speak, and now the North Celestial Pole is directly over our head at the zenith. All of the stars in the Northern Celestial Hemisphere are rotating around us. In fact, you notice that none of them are ever setting. None of them are rising. They're just rotating around us, carousel style. It's worth noting that only the northern half of the sky is visible. Somebody at the South Pole, by the way, on Earth, would likewise see nothing but the southern stars rotating around them. Now let's go ahead and transition from the North Pole down to the equator. So I'm going to set our latitude to 0 degrees, and notice that once again, the North Celestial Pole and or the celestial poles and the equator, celestial equator, are still 90 degrees separated from one another as they are seen from this perspective. But because we're at the equator, the celestial equator is projected onto the sky directly above us. In other words, it starts in the east and ends in the west, but unlike what we saw at home, it passes directly through the zenith. Now, what's interesting about this perspective is that because the north and south celestial poles are directly on the horizon, every star in the entire celestial sphere is visible if you are standing at the equator. Now, we can't see stars during the daytime, we have the sun out, but different stars become visible at night throughout the year. So that means that throughout the year, you will see every star visible from anywhere on Earth at the equator. Okay, so what then about those of us who live at mid-latitudes like most of us do? Let's go ahead and return back home. So go ahead and set us back to approximately our latitude on Earth. And here we are. We see that the celestial sphere continues to appear to rotate around us, but the poles are tilted. And well, we're midway between the Earth's equator and the North Pole, and so the North Celestial Pole is somewhere partway between the horizon and the zenith. It turns out that any star that is in a certain region surrounding the North Celestial Pole, if it's within a certain angle, which just happens to be 38 degrees. So if a star is within 38 degrees of the North Celestial Pole, it will never appear to rise or set. And these stars are known as circumpolar stars. So any star that lies within this red shaded area will never rise or set. I'll go ahead and just drag this star. Let me grab this star really quick. There we go. We'll place it right in there. And you notice that they're never going to set below the horizon from our latitude here in Baltimore. So let's see what this looks like from the ground.